title of the talk is Intellectual Property Law and Post-Scarcity Society. And as the title suggests, the talk is primarily about the role of intellectual property law in a imagined post-scarcity society. There is a lot of talk nowadays about the possibility in this century of some form of a post-scarcity society as a result of various technologies, 3D printing, bioprinting, artificial intelligence, robotics. And one question is, how will intellectual property law function in such a world with this high technology? My talk focuses actually not on the way that intellectual property incentivizes technological change. It actually, the talk focuses on the social role of intellectual property law. And I propose that intellectual property law will essentially supply scarcities to a society that has otherwise, you know, thought that it has solved the problem of scarcity. The background assumption is that society will still demand scarcities for purposes of social distinction. And so the talk is essentially, you know, an easy way to understand it is that it's about status goods, luxury goods, but it's really about much more. It's about how people establish social distinction through consumption and through possession of rarities. The proposal is that intellectual property law will continue to protect these rarities, even in a post-scarcity society. The main prediction of the paper is that if we do actually find ourselves in a post-scarcity society, intellectual property law will still function in a way to preserve scarcities in such a society, supply scarcities to such a society, and even incentivize the production of artificial scarcities that people can consume in order to distinguish themselves through their consumption habits. You might say, that's crazy, that's science fiction, it's not going to happen. One argument I make in the lecture is that intellectual property law is already doing this. It's already functioning in a way that it would in the future in a post-scarcity society. My strongest impression is based on reading about the history of Singapore and realizing that it's still such an incredibly young country and has progressed so rapidly in just a single lifetime. It's absolutely shocking to come here and see the level of development, especially compared to a country like India, where my wife is from. And you see that this place has turned into a first world country really in the blink of an eye. And it's just, it's unbelievable how quickly it has developed. I've seen some of the main shopping areas. I've seen some great restaurants, not fancy restaurants, not the expensive ones, but I've been taken to some sort of local restaurants that were extremely good. I've also seen Gardens by the Bay and was really impressed with how well designed it is and well preserved and well kept it is. Of course, I know it from the movie Crazy Rich Asians, so it was neat to see it up close. And also the Marina Bay Sands Hotel is sort of world famous, if only for its architecture. So it was great to actually see it up close and go inside and have a proper look at it.